in New York. So everybody give it up. Everybody give it up for Ray Ubla, everybody. What's going on, everyone? Yes, good crowd, good crowd. So, why are there no fat ghosts? You never see fat ghosts anywhere. Is it that they don't exist? Or are they just too lazy to haunt shit? You know? Maybe you gotta go to specific places. You gotta find like a Arby's next to a cemetery. Some place where they can go and scare people and comment about how much they love the food. Boo! Oh, curly fries, nice. Love them. So one of you young ladies back there said you're in high school? Is that true? One of you said that? Yeah, they're not listening. I bring that up because I was recently went to do a show in Tysons Corner, Virginia at a beer hall, and in front of me going to the front door was five obvious high school students. And the doorman, when they got there, the doorman just waved them in. Didn't ask them for ID, nothing. And then when I got to the door, he carted me. I don't think that guy understood his job. I'm 47 years old. I don't look like someone that would be in high school. I look like someone they would prevent from being in a high school. You know? Like, I'm not creepy like that, but I know what I look like. If someone told you I went off into the woods to write a manifesto, you would believe it. Okay? You would totally believe that. I read this recently that, I don't know if you heard, OJ did an interview recently. And in his interview, he said that he thought Colin Kaepernick kneeling for the national anthem was a bad idea. I can only hope that someday I do something that OJ Simpson feels the need to publicly say it was a bad idea. You know, there's something strange about getting advice from a double murderer. Alleged double murderer. I have to say alleged. Okay? Because he was found not guilty. So allegedly he killed two people. Just like allegedly I'm on a diet. So, you know. Trump and the NRA want to give guns to teachers. They want to give guns to underpaid, overworked, underappreciated county employees in order to prevent school shootings. Was anyone like me when they heard that their first thought of was which teacher would have shot them when they were in school? For me, it would have been my 7th grade PE teacher, no doubt. There's no way watching me try to do a sit-up would not have pushed him over the edge. You're like, one sit-up! One fucking sit-up! Any Trump supporters here? Yeah, there's some fucking liars here right now, alright? We're in Frederick. I know we're, you know. We saw the red on the map, okay? I am also not a Trump supporter. However, he and I do have something in common. We're both 6'3", 230 pounds. We're both rock hard, clouds. Yeah, if he can say it, so can I, all right? And you don't know, I work hard to maintain this body, okay? Every morning, I wake up at 5 a.m. to go to the gym with a dozen donuts that I eat in front of a spin class. I'm there to motivate. I want those women to know that if they do not work hard, their husbands will fuck their best friends. So, pedal faster, ladies. Am I the fattest comedian you guys ever seen? Yes? No? No? That's disappointing. I want to do special. I do all the open mics at Golden Corral in preparation for that. You know? I used to be a lot bigger. I used to weigh well over 500 pounds. That was about 7-8 years ago. And at that time, I tried to do stand-up, but I had to quit because I would write good material, I think, but I never got to use it. Because what would happen is by the time they'd call me to stage, all I'd have was... a little over 200 pounds. Yay. Thank you. Thank you for applauding it like I say, the baby. Yeah, thank you. I agree, I'm a hero to all of the people. On the hero scale, it goes the troops, first responders, me, and then any woman's ever had sex with me. And history will prove those women to be the greatest heroes, okay? They truly make the ultimate sacrifice of their dignity and self-respect. They will be on stamps one day. I guarantee it. But I've lost enough that I feel comfortable telling people that I'm not fat. I'm just short for my weight. Yeah, if I was 7 feet tall, I'd be lean. Okay? I'd be like Channing Tatum. I mean, with one difference, I have talent, so.
Ouch.
Not yet. Yeah, I know. Fuck Channing Tatum, that's what I'm trying to say. But there have been some benefits to losing weight, as you can imagine. Found my dick. Yeah, applaud that. That was a special moment, all right? Right where I last seen it, which helped. Basically, my dick went from a theoretical concept to a disappointing reality. I guess nothing grows in the shade, is what we take from that. You know? I'm tired of talking about me. Who here has kids? Matt, how old are your kids?
13 and 11.
That must suck. I mean, not your children. I'm sure your children are fine. I'm just saying parenting now sucks. Okay? Because there's so many rules. You know, nowadays, you gotta love them and care for them and feed them and keep a roof up. Who the fuck has time for that shit? Okay? The best time to be a parent, the 1970s. Okay? Because there was only one rule. As long as your kid was still alive by bedtime, job well done. Okay? Didn't matter if they'd been fed, if they were bleeding, if they were missing an arm. It didn't even matter if your kid was home, okay? If your kid got kidnapped in the 1970s, the appropriate parental response was, fuck him, okay? He's the kidnapper's problem now. As long as they send proof of life by bedtime, we're good. Ah, there you go. Picture him with today's paper and a finger. He's fine. I want to leave with guys with this. You guys have been great. Thank you very much. Let's have a round of applause. Okay, that's enough of that shit. Okay. I've been doing stand-up now for 6 months. And I got into this because I grew up idolizing comedians. George Carlin and Richard Pryor and Robin Williams and Lenny Bruce were my heroes growing up. And I just think comics are just the bravest people, man. Because comics come up on stage and they just expose themselves to the world. They expose their insecurities, their flaws, their nuances, everything, just to bring a little bit of joy to people's lives. even if just for a couple minutes. And I think that's just the bravest, most awesome thing in the world. So to all the comics here, I say I appreciate you guys. To comics everywhere, I appreciate the hell out of you guys. And I hope you all as the audience feel the same way. Give it up. I feel the same way about strippers. But they told me I had to keep my clothes on tonight. So, follow your dreams, folks. Thank you very much. You guys have a good night. Give it up for Ray, everybody.
Yeah!
So is parenting that hard, man? Is it?
Is
parenting hard?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah. What about you, Dad? Is parenting hard? See, you want to see a good example of a dad? It's my dad right there. Taking me out to do comedy. Also, me and my dad do acid together all of the time.